Well, hello, special education coordinators and PowerSchool administrators. In this short video today, we're going to show you how to complete data entry in PowerSchool for your students who are on track to earn the state-recognized employability credential and those students who fulfill the requirements to earn that employability credential. I'm here with Kim Watkins from the Office of Special Education Services today, and her office has generated materials that will be helpful to you in understanding what the employability credential is all about and why it is an excellent opportunity and highly meaningful opportunity for eligible students. There are regulation requirements around this credential. Kim, can you tell us a little bit about what's in regulation?
Regulation 43-235 became law in 2018. The employability credential is a state-recognized credential which demonstrates a student has completed requirements indicating the student has developed skills and knowledge to prepare him or her for post-secondary employment and/or education, as well as community-based living as appropriate.
This is an important way that some of your students can advocate for themselves when looking for employment or seeking to continue their education. And of course, we know that you want to ensure that students who are seeking and who then earn the employability credential are accounted for and that they receive their paper employability credential with all of the students earning diplomas and employability credentials in their class. And with that goal in mind, I'm going to show you exactly what needs to be coded in PowerSchool for those students to make sure that these students are recognized, that they are accounted for, and that they can claim their credential. One last note on why accurate data entry for this credential is so important: reporting requirements. Section 5939-100-2D of the South Carolina Code of Laws provides that the department shall monitor the number of diplomas and employability credentials earned by students and shall report to the State Board of Education and the General Assembly biannually by February 15th, beginning in 2020. The second reason that accurate data entry is important is the student, school, and district experience. We want to ensure that paper credentials are shipped to their administrative recipients in a timely manner so that they can be delivered to students on the day of graduation. Note that the employability credential is also available to student recipients digitally, and we hope that they also claim it digitally, as there are many benefits to having that digital version. But we need to stress that for the paper version of the credential, as you can imagine, orders need to be made in a timely manner so that there aren't delays. Let's take a look using a PowerSchool test server with fake data at a 12th grade student who we have just learned from our special education coordinator is on a list of students on track for the employability credential, or who we might say is seeking the employability credential this year. Note that it's first a good idea to look at that student's South Carolina student information page for anything that might need correcting with regard to their instructional setting, this field right here. Students must be special education students at the time that they earn the employability credential. This credential is for eligible 12th grade special education students or those with a true grade of 12, or students who have exited 12th grade and returned to continue their education within the district. So for example, students who are in their first year after 12th grade or second year after 12th grade. If the student is served by a school location that does not include the student's grade level in an acceptable grade range for the employability credential, remember that you would need to have the student's true grade selected in the true grade field. And again, remember that you could have students who have returned after exiting who are seeking the credential, and so just keep that in mind. Now, let's code this student for the fields that specifically reference the employability credential. As soon as you know that the student is seeking the credential, maybe your special education coordinator has provided you with a list of such students, check the Seeking Employability Credential checkbox, as shown right here. Additionally, go ahead and select the appropriate date for the employability credential date field, as shown here. Here from the date pick, June 4th, 2024 has been selected. This field is similar to the graduation date field, but the employability credential date needs to be populated as soon as you know that the student is seeking it. Make sure that you select a date within the correct year that the student is intending to earn it. Finally, you also need to populate the postgraduate student email field that is on this page, if it isn't already populated. Check to make sure the email address looks valid. So for example, there needs to be a domain such as gmail.com. This is a unique identifier that is required for ordering, and it's also required for issuing the credential. So just to recap, once you know that the student is seeking the employability credential, you must go ahead and check the Seeking Employability Credential checkbox, select an employability credential date, and ensure that the postgraduate student email field has been populated with a valid, unique email address. If these elements are not populated, and if the student is not in an eligible grade level or true grade, there will not be a paper credential sent to the administration for the student. So please do this coding as soon as you know who those students are who are on track for the employability credential. And remember, as always, you need to submit the data on this page. Notice that our changes have been saved. Now, as soon as you know that a student has met the requirements for earning the employability credential, you can then populate the employability credential earned checkbox and make sure that you, again, submit the page. So remember that once the paper credentials have been shipped, there's still a window of time there before the employability credential date in which it's possible that the school finds that a student hasn't met all of the requirements. Unfortunately, that could happen. And so the credential is not ultimately valid if that employability credential earned checkbox is not checked and if that data is not submitted. Additionally, in order to make sure that the credential is valid, the employability credential date must also still be populated. For students who do not have both of those pieces of data showing that they earned the credential, those pending issuances will be deleted, and the student will not receive an email with the ability to claim a digital credential. And in those cases, the school or district should dispose appropriately of the paper credential that they were holding. That's what you need to know about PowerSchool data entry for the employability credential. As always, just a reminder to our district PowerSchool administrators that correct data entry is crucial, of course, but you also need to ensure that required data make it up to the South Carolina Department of Education. If district PowerSchool administrators have any questions about how to make sure that this has happened, please reach out to the data collection team at powerschool@ed.sc.gov. Thank you so much for watching. We hope that your eligible students are on track to earn the employability credential, and we look forward to congratulating you on your recipients later this year.